Hey guys, last time we have covered up the types of batteries and working of lithium-ion battery. Please check out that video before starting this. The link is in description. In this video, we are going to see parameters of battery based on what a battery is selected for our electric vehicle, which are state of charge, depth of discharge, C rate, state of health, state of power, etc., etc. We'll also see the physical properties of a cell, such as terminal voltage, open circuit voltage, internal resistance, life cycle, specific energy, specific power, and so on. So, buckle up guys, let's go for a ride. Even in lithium-ion batteries, all cells are not created equally. Batteries can provide either high power or high energy. There is a trade-off between both of these quantities. Another common classification factor is high durability. So if a single battery provides all these things, then there is nothing more promising than that. We'll see some parameters on which a battery is compared. And some of these parameters are mentioned in a datasheet of a battery, or a battery management system has to calculate them. Very first is the capacity of a battery. It is given in ampere hour or milliampere hour. Let's understand it by knowing as C and E rates. A C rate is a measurement unit at which a battery is discharged or charged relative to its maximum capacity. A 1C rate is the current at which the battery will discharge entirely in 1 hour. For example, a battery is having 1C capacity of 10 ampere hours. That means, theoretically, it can provide 10 amperes of current for a whole hour and then its juice runs out and it fully discharges. If we take the 2C rate of this battery, then it would be 20 amperes. If we draw 20 amperes continuously from this battery, then it will discharge within 30 minutes. And a C by 2 capacity would be 5 amperes. It will take 2 hours to discharge that battery fully. So how much maximum current can a battery provide for discharging is measured by this quantity, and it is defined by the manufacturer of the battery. It also comes handy to define the maximum charging current of a battery. Similarly, an E rate describes the discharge power. A 1E rate is the power required to discharge the entire battery in 1 hour. This is similar to C rate, but the unit and significance is different. Next comes the state of charge. This thing shows the remaining capacity of the battery while in use. We can say it's a fuel gauge of a battery. We see state of charge of a battery of our electronic devices every day in percentage. Next is the depth of discharge. It indicates the percentage capacity of the battery which has been discharged relative to the overall ideal capacity of the battery. It is always recommended that a battery should never be fully charged or discharged. Frequent charging and discharging shortens the life of a battery. If a battery pack's capacity is of 10 kWh and cell manufacturer suggests to keep the depth of discharge 90%, that means only 9 kWh energy has to be used, and then keep the battery for charging again. Battery should never be charged 100% and should never be discharged up to 0%. This way, keeping a significant depth of discharge can increase the battery life. Next is the state of health of a battery. It represents a maximum measurement of a battery's ability to store and deliver electrical energy compared with a new battery. If a battery is not able to store at least the 80% energy capacity as compared to a new battery of the same size, even if it is fully charged, then it is considered that the battery has reached to its end of life. Next comes the state of power. It is the battery's present ability to provide power under certain voltage and current limits. The state of power depends on the SOC, SOH, temperature and time. For example, when SOC of battery A is 10% and SOC of battery B is 80%, then SOP of battery A will be far less than battery B because there is direct relation of power and energy. So SOP of battery is important and it has to be accurately predicted or calculated in real time. So these parameters need to be calculated or analyzed, but to do so we need some physical parameters based on which we can do the calculations. So let's see the physical properties of a cell. First is the terminal voltage. The battery is the source of our electric vehicle. When we connect a voltmeter across a battery, the value which we get is the terminal voltage of a battery. In our case, load is motor. This terminal voltage varies with state of charge and charge discharge current. Next comes the open circuit voltage. This is the voltage between the battery terminals when there is no load. The open circuit voltage also depends on the battery's state of charge and it increases or decreases with the SOC. For lithium ion batteries, when state of charge is at 10%, the open circuit voltage can be as low as 3 volts, and when SOC is 95%, then open circuit voltage can be up to 3.7 volts. Next comes the internal resistance. It is the resistance of a battery and it changes while charging and discharging. It is also dependent on the state of charge of the battery. As internal resistance increases, the efficiency of the battery decreases and cell becomes thermally unstable and it generates heat. Next is the nominal voltage. It is a reference voltage of the battery, also called as normal voltage of the battery. This thing is mentioned on the cell itself. Next comes the cutoff voltage. This is the minimum allowable voltage up to which we can use this battery. If we reach this voltage level, that means the battery is fully empty. Next is the life cycle of a battery. How many numbers of charge-discharge cycle a battery can experience before it fails to perform well? The actual operating life of the battery is affected by rate and depth of charge-discharge cycles and by other conditions such as temperature and humidity. The higher the depth of discharge, the lower the cycle life of a battery. Next is the specific energy. It is the nominal energy stored in a battery per unit mass. It is also referred as the energy density. Specific energy is a characteristic of the battery chemistry and packaging. It determines the battery weight required to achieve a given electric range. Next is the specific power, which is given in watt per kg. It is the maximum available power of a battery per unit mass. It is also characteristic of the battery chemistry and packaging. It determines the battery weight required to achieve particular performance. Next comes the maximum continuous discharge current. It is the maximum current at which the battery can be discharged continuously. This limit is defined by the battery manufacturer in order to prevent excessive discharge rates, which might damage the battery or reduce its capacity. Many times it is given in the terms of C rate of the battery. Next is the float voltage. This voltage is applied when the battery is supposed to maintain its 100% state of charge after being fully charged. This voltage prevents self-discharging of the battery. Generally, for lithium-ion cell, this voltage is around 4.2 volt. Well, it may change according to the cell chemistry. So these parameters has to be considered while checking the battery. When you read the datasheet of the battery, these all parameters are mentioned in it. Well, that's not it. Even in lithium-ion batteries, there are numerous types. But we'll check those next time. So that's it for now. Comment down below if you have any questions. Hit the like button if you like this video. Subscribe to my channel. And finally, thanks for watching.